fourth man advantage. Their last one lasted only 51 seconds. And it's a battle off the faceoff. Henrique lost his stick. And now we got a penalty coming up as he and Payton were mixing it up. And now everybody meets in the corner.
The original penalty is going against Adam Henrique, who upends Hayton over by the boards. And that's why you saw Adam give Hayton a shove. He thought that he went down maybe a little bit too easy. Don't know if there's going to be anything else called other than that.
Trevor Zegras not stopping the conversation as Troy Stetcher, he drew his ire there. Linesman trying to intercede but not having a great deal of success right now. Finally, Zegras pulled from the fray. And Stetcher's incensed. And if I can read lips, Hazy, I think he said, "I don't like it."
He's still kind of challenging Zegras.
Zegras all the way to the neutral zone. Let's see if we can relive it.
Well, here's the original penalty against Henrique right there as he comes back with the right arm, and he thought Hayton embellished, so he gave him another shot, as did Zegras. And then it was on at that point. Stetcher jumped into the fray.
Looked like he threw a punch. And I don't know if he's getting more than Trevor Zegras. They appear to be sending him either just to the bench, or is he getting a penalty and going to the locker room? Looks like Stetcher's, at least for the moment, he has not been escorted to the penalty box, so I don't know if he's getting any penalties at all. Zegras joins Henrique in the Anaheim sin bin. So the Ducks power play lasts 9 seconds off the tripping penalty to the netminder Connor Ingram. And now we wait at Honda Center to see just how many penalties are called and how it affects the manpower situation with 6:23 to go in the second.
Andre Tourney listening to Stetcher, who's one of the more veteran players on this roster,
and he is very worked up. Former All-American at North Dakota, Stetcher was undrafted, now in his sixth NHL season. And the officials are still mulling it over. Cam Fowler is talking with the referee. And we've had no announcement yet. They put no penalty time up on the board, so
Dallas Aikens getting an explanation now over at the Anaheim bench. They have yet to call any additional players over to the box.
About 15,000 people in this building that have no idea what's going on, including the coaching staffs, as the officials are sharing with them right now. They put two up for Henrique on the board. We're told Zegras has picked up a minor penalty as well as a misconduct. And were that to be the case, the Ducks would be shorthanded out of this. The scoreboard doesn't reflect anything for Zegras at this moment.
And Stetcher remains over at the Coyotes bench, and you can see Tourney is trying to figure out what's going on over there as well. Stetcher's still on the ice, and he seems to have calmed down a little bit.
It appears as if maybe it's just a 10-minute misconduct on Zegras, because it's not reflected on the scoreboard that he was given any minor penalties. And it's going to be 4-on-4. When and if we get back to hockey.
Well, they're taking the faceoff down into Anaheim territory.
So now Baron Hayton comes over to the Arizona penalty box. He was given a 2-minute minor for roughing, and that would nullify the minor that was given to Zegras. So, and unfortunate part for Dallas Aikens is obviously you lose one of your best players for a large chunk of time here.
Barrett Hayden, 2 minutes for roughing. For the Ducks, number 11, Trevor Zegras, 2 minutes roughing plus a 10-minute misconduct. Also for the Ducks, number 14, Adam Henrique, 2 minutes high sticking. Time of the penalties, 13:37. Again, for Arizona, 29, Barrett Hayden, 2 minutes roughing.